dinner.
Hey guys, it's Keegan. So first off, I want to say I'm really sorry for being gone for so long. A lot of things just happened and I couldn't film videos. But I'm back and there's like this glare. Sorry about that. Today I'm going to be doing a fall inspired makeup tutorial and it incorporates a lot of golds and orangey browns and I really like it. I've been wearing it a lot and I just really like it. And it was kind of hard to film because I had to use the viewfinder, so it turns out better when I don't have to use the viewfinder, just to let you know that. But I really like this look. I think it's so pretty for the fall time. And just for you guys, I wore a huge sweater, even though it's 100 degrees outside. But I did it for you. So I hope you guys like this video, and I just have been liking it a lot. I've been wearing it a lot. And I am just obsessed with it. Hopefully you guys will like it.
I'm really thirsty. Am I the only one who does this? Put their straw in their water bottle? I saw it on H2O and I was like, I'm doing that.
Off topic again, sorry. Yeah. So, again, like 50 times later, hope you like this video. I will see you right now. So I'm starting off with a bare face and I'm going to moisturize my lips with this Nivea Lip Butter in Smooth Kiss because we want them to be moisturized and everything. So for the eyes, I'm starting off with my Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion, which is my favorite primer that I've tried, and I'm using my ring finger to blend it out because it's your softest finger for your soft little gentle eyes. That did not make any sense, sorry. But yes, I'm blending that out. And don't forget to bring it on your lower lash line because we'll be putting shadow there. And I have a Naked Basics palette. I'm taking Walk of Shame. It's like a neutral pink color. And I'm just applying that on my lid up to my brow bone. Just to cancel out veins and make a very nice space for our shadows. And I'm using a flat shader brush by Sigma. I'm using a lot of Sigma brushes in this tutorial. I'll link their website down below. And out of this old e.l.f. palette that like the lid broke off and everything, I don't even know if they still sell it, I'm taking this orangey brown color and applying this into my crease very sloppily. Is sloppily even a word? I don't know. Not very precise and nicely, like just throwing it in there. And of course, doing that to the other eye. We'll be using the shadow a lot. You don't need this exact shadow, just a orangey brown color. I think those colors are very pretty for the fall time. So yes, now I'm taking this maroon brownish color from the same palette, and again, sloppily, even if that's not even a word, we're going to use it in the outer corner and turning into a V. I'm not doing this very nicely because we're going to be going over it again, so yeah, we don't need to make it very nice, it's just throwing it in there for like now, I don't know what to say, sorry. And yes, I'm using a Sigma tapered blush. Brush, a tapered blending brush, and I'm taking that orangey brown color again into the crease to intensify it because, like I said, we're using this color a lot. This is not going to be the only time we're going to use it again, trust me. So, just putting that in there, and I'm taking an angled brush and just blending out the lines and edges. And out of their Naked 2 palette, I am taking Verve, which is a pretty taupe color, and this step is not necessary, but I'm just putting this in the center of my lid. And yeah, and that's what it looks like. Now I'm taking Half Baked, which is a gold color, which I love, and we're taking that on the inner two-thirds of our eyes. And I did this step, like, I probably layered it over like 3 times just to make it very intensified and just make it very bold. And once again, that orangey-brown color, it's going back in the crease. We're gonna use it a lot, trust me. So just blend in there, both eyes, you don't want to do it on just one eye, that'd be weird. And now I'm taking that dark brown color again and just putting it in the outer corner like I did before. And just on the inner third, I'm just going to put the gold in there again just to make it intensified. And I'm taking Foxy from the Naked Basics palette and I'm highlighting my brow bone. And also, if you accidentally kind of messed up on your shadow, like the crease color, You can use this to kind of mute the color so they're not as, like, harsh. And I'm taking this in the inner corner. And sorry, I was singing a song. My bad. And I am taking this maroon color and just lining my lower lash line just to make them a little bit fuller. And I really like this color. And I'm using the Stila All Day Liquid Waterproof Eyeliner and just lining my eyes. I'm not winging out. I'm just doing it very thin. You can barely even see it. But I did not get a good shot of it. Sorry. And I didn't get a lot of fallout, but I'm just wiping any fallout away. That's why I did my eyes first. And now I'm moisturizing. I probably should have moisturized before my eyes, but hey, I forgot. So I'm just going to blend this in. This is by Yes2 Cucumbers, and I absolutely love it. It's amazing. I would totally recommend if you have dry combination skin like I do. And there I am posing. Yeah, I'm not attractive. Sorry. And I'm taking the CoverGirl 3-in-1 foundation on the back of my hand with the Real Techniques Expert face brush. And I'm just dabbling that onto my face first. And then I'm going to take circular motions on my face. If you have pores, like large pores, you can use circular motions and that'll make them smaller. So yes, and I'm in the color Ivory. And check out my brow. That was totally weird. Did you see that? And I'm just blending it all over my face. And I'm taking my Olay & CoverGirl Simply Ageless Concealer that's like cracked and melted and disgusting, but it still works. So just put that under your eyes and try to avoid that maroon shadow. If you need to, you can go over it again, but I didn't really get it, so on the maroon shadow. And I am taking this translucent powder by Too Faced, it's the HD one, and I'm setting that under my eyes, on my nose, on my forehead, and on my chin. I didn't get a shot of my chin, sorry. And I'm taking my favorite powder of all time, which is Stay Matte by Rimmel. And I'm just dusting on the outsides of my face because I don't want those to be oily. And I couldn't find my contour brush, so I just used this one by e.l.f. And I'm just contouring my cheekbones with Hoola Bronzer. And you start from the top of your ear, and then you go towards the edge of your eye. And here I am blending it out with my powder brush by Sigma. And I'm taking NARS Orgasm with a Sigma and Gold Blush brush, and I'm just applying that. It's a really pretty, like, peach, kind of, with, like, gold glitter shimmer, I don't know, but it's so pretty fall. And I'm taking the Revlon Just Bitten Kiss Bow Lip Stain in Honey, and I think it's really pretty, and I love this because it's moisturizing and stains and everything. And the Buxom Lip Gloss in Dolly, and I'm just applying this to the center of my lids to make my lips look bigger because I have pretty small lips. And now I'm curling my lashes with my Maybelline Big Eyes mascara, and I really like this one. I've been trying this out, and I always make unattractive faces whenever I do my mascara. And now I'm taking the smaller brush that it comes with for my lower lashes, and here I am posing, trying to be cute, but I am so not. I was like laughing, and yeah, I wore a sweater for you guys even though it's like 100 degrees outside. Hope you guys appreciate that. I'm not good at posing. I'm very sorry about that. But here is what the look looks like. Huh? Look? Yeah? Okay, no. But, yes, I love you guys so much, and I will talk to you later. Bye!
It's hot in here. I hope you guys like this video.
That was cute.
A visionary, a player, so you know I have some girls missionary.
Oh my gosh, my background matches my sweater.